Hi, everybody. I'm Bill Dolman, along with Chad Hafe. Welcome to Memorial Stadium in Lincoln. This is the Class D1 State Championship game between the Humphrey St. Francis Flyers and the Mullen Broncos. Both teams come into this game 11-1 on the season. Mullen ranked fourth in the state. Humphrey St. Francis ranked number nine. And, Chad, we have two very different football teams on the field today. One very powerful, one very big, and one very fast.
We talked to both coaches before the game, and Coach Brown said we're going to run, and that's all we're going to do unless they make us pass. And Humphrey St. Francis was on the other side said, we're going to do what they give us. We'll run, we'll pass, we'll see what they do in the first couple series, and we'll base our game off that. So we have a very exciting game, sunny, 35 degrees out in Memorial Stadium, a great time for these kids to come out here and play on Tom Osborne Field.
It is a terrific morning for football here in Lincoln. Both teams won loss on the year, and both coaches credit those losses for turning their seasons around, although they've had a lot of success this year. Humphrey St. Francis was unbeaten, lost in the final regular season game to Lindsay Holy Family, 32-27. Head coach Tom Ritter called that an eye-opener for his squad. He said, you know, there's a lot of pressure on being unbeaten, no matter what level you play, but that loss was one that really propelled them into a good run here in the state playoffs. Let's go now to Memorial Stadium, PA, announcer Rick Schwieger for the introduction of the Humphrey St. Francis Flyers.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Nebraska School Activities Association and U.S. Bank would like all of you to recognize the outstanding accomplishments of these two football teams. Let's welcome and introduce our visitors from Humphrey St. Francis High School. Number 3, Mike Turnus. Number 8, Paul Rollman. Number 12, Jeff Hasenstab. Number 18, Kaylee Baumgart. Number 20, John Wessel. Number 21, Jamie Court. Number 24, Adam Hamlin.
He said Kaylee.
Yeah, it says short A.
Number 25, Josh Besh.
Would you say Callie?
Number 28, Jesse Seeper. Number 31, Jesse Bender. Number 40, Brandon Pfeiffer. Number 43, Todd Frondorfer. Number 53, Eric Frondorfer. Number 55, Nick Wimhoff. Number 73, Jason Anderson. Number 75, Alan Anderson. Number 80, Justin Helmer. Number 81, Ben Hansel. Number 84, Andy Clausen. Number 85, Tyler Zock. Number 88, Justin Pfeiffer. And number 99, Tim Turnus, the head coach of Humphrey St. Francis. It's Tom Ritter and the rest of the Flyers.
Humphrey St. Francis is making its 16th appearance in the state tournament, 11-1 on the year, as we talked about a moment ago. They were the runner-up back in 1998, but they also won two state championships in 1995 and again in 1996. They know what it's like to play here in Memorial Stadium. Mullen, on the other hand, they are also 11-1, the number one team in the state for much of the season. This is a very good football team, and they had a feeling at the beginning of the year that they could be here to compete for a state championship. Let's go back to Rick Schwieger for the introduction of the Mullen Broncos.
Now, let's meet the players for the home team of Mullen High School. Number 10, Nick Simonson. Number 13, Joel Jacobs. Number 20, Gary Isom. Number 31, Willie Hicks. Number 33, Eric Peterson. Number 34, Randy Huddle. Number 42, Joseph Mackey. Number 51, Roger Licking. Number 52, Sean Peterson. Number 63, Casey Phillips. Number 70, R.J. Hardy. Number 74, Tyler Krause. Number 81, Jesse Severe. Number 83, Justin Young. And number 85, David Reitenauer. And the head coach of the Broncos, Mike Brown. And the rest of the Mullen Broncos.
It's a long trip from Mullen, Nebraska to Lincoln. And the Broncos made their trek yesterday morning at 9 a.m. They practiced at Centennial High School, about 50 miles west of Lincoln. And they are in Lincoln. They saw yesterday's eight-man D2 state championship game, and they are here now to try and win the Class D1 state title. We're going to take a break before kickoff. We'll come back with action in the first quarter right after this.
Genuine Nebraska, where opportunity is as open as our landscape. It's a land of prosperity, discovery, and community, where the best things in life are priceless and can be yours for the asking, where work is plentiful and rewards are generous. Come home to Nebraska, a great place to work, play, and stay. Genuine Nebraska.
With Chet Haight, I'm Bill Dolman. Welcome back to Memorial Stadium in Lincoln. We're about set to go with action in the Class D1 state championship game for 1998. Mullen 11-1 taking on Humphrey St. Francis 11-1, and the Flyers will kick the football away to the Broncos to begin playing this football game, and that, Chad, is going to give that Broncos high-powered offense a chance right off the bat to set the tone.
Yes, it is. Coach Brown said they're going to run the football and continue to run until Humphrey St. Francis can stop them. And when we were down there with those guys, they are much bigger than Humphrey St. Francis. So it will be a big challenge today for the Flyers to try to stop the Broncos on the ground.
Yeah, there is a distinct size advantage, although Mullen does fear the speed that Humphrey St. Francis does have in its lineup. And you talk to Tom Ritter, and he knows he's got a pretty quick ball club, but can they match up with that size of Mullen? And they know one thing. We talked to Tom Ritter before the game, the Humphrey St. Francis coach. He said they're going to do one thing. They're going to sweep, sweep, sweep. We know they're going to do it. We've just got to stop it. And they'll have a chance to stop it right here, right off the bat, as Humphrey St. Francis kicks the football away to Mullen. Deep to receive for the Broncos will be number 42, Joseph Mackey, one of the outstanding running backs for the Broncos, 5'8", 145-pound senior. He's the lone setback. And Jason Anderson, number 73, will tee it up for the Flyers. And we're getting set to go with the action in Class D1.
Mullen is bigger than Humphrey St. Francis, but Coach Ritter did tell us before the game that every team's been bigger than Humphrey St. Francis this year, and they're 11-1, so maybe that isn't as big a factor. We'll have to see.
Boy, the Flyers got the season off to a great start. 50-0 win over Humphrey. Knocked off Spencer Napier, Clarkson. Had shutout wins back-to-back over Dodge and Lee. And defeated Howells, Newman Grove before falling in the season finale to Lindsay Holy Family. In the playoffs, they've defeated Verdigris, Clarkson again, Bancroft Rosalie, and they beat Polk Cordville in the semifinals 25-14 to earn a trip to Lincoln. Mullen, well, they got off to a great start as well. Wins over Anselmo, Myrna, Thedford, Hyannis, Sandhills, Harrisburg, Sargent before losing 46-42 to Ansley. Then they knocked off Crawford, who at that time was number one in the state, a 42-20 win. And they defeated Medicine Valley, Paxton, and they beat Crawford again 20-14 in the quarters, and Chambers in the semis, 40-20, and that's how they got here to Lincoln. We are set to go. The ball teed up. Anderson puts a foot into it, and Mackey will accept it in the end zone, and he's going to bring it out 3 yards deep along that far sideline. He's tripped up and knocked out of bounds at the 13-yard line. May not have been the wisest decision in the world to bring that football out 5 yards deep in the end zone.
Maybe wanted that first contact right off the bat to get the nerves out of the way, the butterflies out of the stomach. Decided to take it out, and they're at about the 15-yard line.
And quarterback Nick Simonson, or tailback Nick Simonson, will be set behind the quarterback Joel Jacobs, and that is a big, big backfield for Mullen. Jacobs at 6'4", 210 pounds. Simonson, 6'2", 190. Mackey's also back there from time to time at 5'8", 145. But this is a big football team. It'll be first down and 10. They do spot the ball at the 15-yard line. And it'll be Jacobs leading the troops. So the fullback is Simonson. Mackey, tight set in the eye. And it's Mackey off the right side. Upended after a 3-yard gain, just shy of the 20-yard line. And it'll be a pickup of 3, second down and 7.
Like we said before, they're going to run the football, and Mackey had the ball off to the right side, as you see. Adam Hamley, number 24, with a nice tackle, brings up second down.
And they sweep it with Mackey. Big hole off the right side, run out of bounds by 18, Callie Baumgarten. And it'll be just shy of the first down by about a half a yard.
And Coach Ritter was right. Sweep, sweep, sweep. It's been 2 sweeps in a row for the Broncos of Mullen.
Third down and less than 1 on the opening drive of the game. Tight set. Give us to the fullback Simonson. He lunges forward, and he should have enough for the first down. And they'll move the chains.
On third and short distances today, Bill, you got to think that Mullen does have the advantage with the size. On third and ones, they're going to get the offensive line to burst forward and get that 1 yard they need. And they did that time.
Went off the right side that time behind Sean Peterson, a 5'11", 205-pound guard. First and 10 from the 25. Movement on the defensive side. And Simonson is stacked up and run back. Good penetration and a good wall set up by that defensive front for the Flyers. And they're going to spot him all the way back to the 21-yard line. His initial progress was to the line of scrimmage. He bounced outside, tried to make something happen. And that's going to be a big loss on the play.
Simonson had nowhere to go here. Todd Frondendorf. Great penetration up the middle to get the 4-yard loss.
Second down, 14. Again, this Mullen football team doesn't like to throw it, but they do throw it here. Good pressure on. The pass is complete. Penalty flag on the play. There was contact before the completion was made. It's hauled in by 83, Justin Young. He'll be shy of the first down marker by about 3 yards. Nice toss from Jacobs.
The great play action by Jacobs, as you see Justin Young go out and get bumped a little bit. Great concentration, catches the ball, and it probably should be pass interference here, which would give him an automatic first down.
Oh, yeah, do you take the play or do you take the penalty? And with a pass interference penalty, I would imagine they would take that and pick up the first down. But they'll talk it over with Simonson. He's also down there with Roger Licking. And Young is also in there. Young doesn't want to lose the reception.
Yeah, they don't throw the ball too much. He needs all the receptions he can get out here in the state championship game.
He leads this team. He had 24 catches during the regular season. And it is a first down on the penalty. They'll mark off the 15 yards. And that'll set the football down at the 36-yard line. So take away the reception for Young, but it's a nice play. And that really does kind of set the tone for Jacobs and company. Hey, he can throw the football if he has to.
And that's got to worry Humphrey St. Francis, because if they can run and pass, they're going to have to balance their defense out a little bit, not stack everybody up on the line, and that could make it easier for Mullen to run the football.
First down and 10, the ball spotted at the 36-yard line. The Broncos out near midfield. And this is Simonson, the fullback, with the big hole up the middle, and he's into Flyer territory down to the 33-yard line.
A great hole opened up by the offensive line. That size showed right there against the defensive front. Opened up a big hole for Simonson to go through for a big gain and a first down. You can see in the replay there, big hole for the fullback to run through. Picks up 10 yards before he's touched.
And if Adam Hamling's not there, it's 6. First and 10, they spot it at the 32, and they'll sweep it with Mackey. Got a block from Simonson, bounces to the outside, and he's ridden down at the 26-yard line. In there to make the tackle was Callie Baumgart, the safety.
And right there on that sweep, you see the speed of Humphrey St. Francis defense. Callie Baumgart coming from the safety position all the way over to the left side to make the tackle. Great speed, great tackle by number 18, Baumgart.
Second down and four, a pickup of six. Quick handoff to Simonson, the fullback, and he picks up a yard on the play. Tackled by 55, Nick Wimhoff, the junior nose tackle.
Smash mouth football is what the Broncos of Mullen are playing right now, with Simonson going up the middle trying to wear down this defense of Humphrey St. Francis. Brings up third down, a big third down and short.
Still on the opening drive of the game, third down and three. The ball at the 25 of the Flyers. This is Mackey, quick into the hole, fumbled the football, and did he get it back? Still no indication, and apparently he did. But it'll be spotted shy of the first down by about a half a yard. We're going to have an official's timeout for measurement. Well, that could have been a big, big break in the early part of this ball game. Mullen has been moving the football well, and Humphrey St. Francis, if they could have pounced on the loose ball.
As you see on that replay, the big Nick Simonson trying to lead the blocking way for Mackey. Mackey loses the ball, but great instincts and gets the ball back.
Well, instead of a half yard shy, it's about a half foot shy. Fourth down and inches. And the way they've moved the football here on this opening drive, that's not a very big task for this Bronco football team. But if Humphrey St. Francis can use their quickness to get some penetration, that would be a big break defensively in this football game in the early going. And they give it to the fullback, Simonson. He's stacked up at the line of scrimmage, and I'm not sure he got there.
Great penetration by the Humphrey St. Francis defensive line. Just the speed got over the power there, and I think they're going to hold him here. We'll have to see on the measurement.
They'll bring the chains out. That was fourth down and 6 inches, and they got it by the nose of the football.
Nick Simonson, with a second and third effort, was the reason why they got that. He got stopped at the line, rolled around to the right side, and this forward progress must have gotten the first down.
First and 10, the ball will be just outside the 22-yard line. This keeps this opening drive alive. What a big lift that would have been for Humphrey St. Francis. Instead, it's Mullen still on the move. Simonson again up the middle, fighting for yards, down to the 15-yard line. Now, there's no secret as to what Mullen wants to do. Well, it must be a secret. They line up their huddle about 20 yards behind the football.
Number 51, Roger Licking, the center, leading the way on that offensive line, blowing through the defense, giving room for Simonson to blow through.
They're lined up back at the 43-yard line. Second down and three, a pickup of seven. Here's Mackey on the sweep. He's got a hole, and he's ridden out of bounds at the 9-yard line. That's enough yardage for the first down, and first and goal now for the Broncos.
Mackey with the sweep right here, as you'll see, kind of a Justin Young making a big block from the wide receiver position. Allows Mackey to get a couple extra yards. First and goal.
Just shy of the nine. Jacobs turns, pitches, sweep to the left side, and Mackey has tripped up after a yard gain down to the 8-yard line.
Number 88, Justin Pfeiffer there for Humphrey St. Francis, making Mackey turn back up inside and allowing the rest of his defensive partners to make the tackle on Mackey.
See, Jacobs, the quarterback, 13 out there leading the way once he pitched the football. Simonson, the fullback, also trying to block on the play. Second down and goal, the ball at the 8-yard line. Mullen looking for points on the opening drive of the game. Here's Simonson straight up the middle and knocked down at the 1-yard line. Well, it looked like he had six on that carry. A great tackle by number 88, Justin Pfeiffer.
Great call there by Coach Brown. A counter trap with the fullback, Nick Simonson. As you'll see here, Simonson right up the middle and stopped at the 1-yard line by number 18, Callie Baumgart.
Third down and goal from the one. Simonson straight up the middle for the touchdown.
Smash mouth football is what the Mullen Broncos play, and all the way down the field is what they did. Nick Simonson with the 1-yard run right up the middle, and they lead 6-0 on the opening drive.
A one-yard touchdown run by Nick Simonson has put the Broncos on the board first. And now the point after conversion. Mackey will be stopped short of the goal line. And our score will stay. Mullen 6 and Humphrey St. Francis nothing. The Flyers have yet to touch the football. A terrific drive to open up this football game for Mullen. And, Chad, I would imagine that's what this football team wants to do. They just want to grind it out, pound it at you, wear you down defensively, and they did it on that opening drive.
And a big play on fourth down and one. Simonson's second and third effort kept the drive alive and kept the momentum with the Mullen Broncos to allow them to drive down the field and score on their opening possession. But now we'll see what Humphrey St. Francis can do with their first possession. See if their speed can outdo the power of the Broncos.
4 minutes, 47 seconds taken off the clock by Mullen on their first drive of the game. Humphrey St. Francis will have their first crack at it. Simonson has it teed up at the 30-yard line. Baumgart back deep to receive, along with number 24, Adam Hamling. Baumgart, the Flyers quarterback, Hamling a running back, and this will be Hamling taking it at the 4. And he'll take it to the left side, cut back up to the middle, and he's brought down at the 16-yard line, and that's where the Flyers will set up shop. Seven minutes, 8 seconds remaining in the opening period of play of this Class D1 state championship. The Flyers of Humphrey St. Francis ranked number 9 in the state, 11-1 on the year. They average about 37 points a game. Defensively, they only give up 16. And offensively, averaging about 323 yards a game. Split back set for Baumgart. And it'll be Baumgart keeping it himself. And he's driven back by a whole host of Broncos, namely number 13, Joel Jacobs, that quarterback who led that great drive.
You look at this offense and defense right now, and this is where you really see the size advantage for the Mullen Broncos. Joel Jacobs, 6'4", 210. The biggest player on Humphrey St. Francis is their quarterback, Callie Baumgart, and he's 6 foot 158, so we'll see what he can do against this defense.
Hamling the fullback, Justin Pfeiffer is the tailback. And Baumgart wants to throw. He's got a man open, and the pass is caught! Caught by number 43, Todd Frondorfer. And that's enough for a Flyer first down.
Great play there by Humphrey St. Francis. They know they're outside. They might have to go through the air. And speed over power will definitely work in the passing game. Great catch by Todd Frauendorfer.
First down and 10, the ball at the 37-yard line. A pickup of 20 on the play. Baumgart, an errant pitch to Pfeiffer, and he's got to recover it. And that'll be a big loss back to the 28-yard line. A loss of 9 on the play. That'll bring up second down and 19. And when you're behind to a team like Mullen, who's been ranked number 1 in the state this year, you just cannot afford to make mistakes like this, especially after you come up with a big play of your own. That just kills the momentum.
An error-free game is what Humphrey St. Francis definitely needs to win this football game. Luckily, they recovered that fumble. Second and 19.
Pfeiffer and Hamling split behind Baumgart. Tight set, Baumgart wants to throw. They'll set up the screen, and the pass is too far out in front of Pfeiffer. Pressure was put on by Joel Jacobs, the defensive end, and that'll bring up third down and 19.
Offensive line lets the defense go through here to set up the screen pass, but Joel Jacobs, with great speed, gets the Baumgartner very quickly, and number 88 goes just off his fingertips.
Third down, 19, and I would imagine this would mean the Flyers have to put the ball in the air. 5:52 to play. Mullen leading 6-0. And Baumgart wants to throw. It'll be a quarterback draw straight up the middle to the 40 or 35-yard line. Lunges forward to the 40 to the 38. But it'll be well short of a first down. Fourth down and 8 now. Make it 9. And the Flyers will have to punt the football away.
Third and 19, they're going to play it safe, not allow a big turnover. The quarterback draw with the big Callie Baumgart, who drives forward there, great leg power to get up to midfield.
And Humphrey St. Francis will punt. Mackey back deep to receive. Good snap, and the punt by Nick Wemhoff A fair catch is called for at the 16-yard line, and that's where Mullen will take over. 5 minutes, 5 seconds remaining in the opening quarter in the Class D1 state championship game. Mullen leads Humphrey St. Francis 6-0.
And Humphrey St. Francis needs a three and out here to get the confidence back, the momentum back to their side. Mullen here is going to try to run again, see if they can march it down the field and take up a lot of time here to not allow Humphrey St. Francis to get back in this.
Jacobs turns and is tripped up at the line of scrimmage, and he may have lost a yard. Broncos were trying to run the option.
Joel Jacobs, number 13, trips over his center, number 51, Roger Licking here on the play. So his own man tackled him. Maybe that's the best play for Humphrey St. Francis so far.
Nick Wimhoff, the nose tackle, was the one who tied up Licking. And a loss of one, second down and 11 now from the 15-yard line. Jacobs to throw. The pass is over the head of the intended receiver, Justin Young. Dangerous throw. There were a couple of flyers in the area, and that could have been intercepted.
Humphrey St. Francis bringing everybody up in the box here to stop the run, and a quick pattern like that allows the safeties and corner to come up and double-team Justin Young.
Licking the center. Jacobs behind him. Simonson the fullback, and Mackey will stay in the block. Jacobs has pressure, lofts one up for Young, and well out of bounds. And the Flyers stand defensively.
And that's exactly what I said. They needed three and out. Confidence is up for Humphrey St. Francis now. The momentum might be shifting. They're going to get great field position. Number 18, Callie Baumgart. Excuse me, number 88, Justin Pfeiffer back in midfield, so they should get great field position.
And Jacobs will punt. Nearly blocked. Jacobs got it away, and it goes out of bounds at the 28-yard line. The pressure came in from the left side by 43, Todd Frondorfer. He may have got a piece of that football. He had great penetration on Jacobs, and, boy, if he didn't get a piece of it, he didn't miss it by much, and the ball goes off the side of the foot. And like you said, great field position now for Humphrey St. Francis. First down and 10. They spot the football at the Bronco 28-yard line. 4 minutes, 19 seconds remaining in the first quarter. Justin Pfeiffer, the lone setback. The quarterback is Callie Baumgart. A good pitch this time to Pfeiffer, and a slow developing play gets a couple of yards.
This Mullen defense isn't just powerful, though. They're quick. They get out to the left and right sides very quickly to make this stop here. You'll see Baumgart with the option. And there's the defense sitting right there to stop it for a minimal gain.
Gain of two, second down and eight. The ball at the 26 of Mullen. Split back set this time. And Baumgart wants to throw. And the pass is knocked away. Incomplete. Intended for Josh Wessel, number 20. Covering on the play, number 31, Willie Hicks, the defensive back. That'll bring a third down and eight.
Wessel and Frondorfer running crossing patterns here to try to free up themselves, and number 10 with a great stop there, Nick Simonson.
Third down and eight. The ball at the 26-yard line. And a counteraction this time. Here's the run by Adam Hamling. He's got some open territory down the sideline, and he steps out of bounds at the 3-yard line.
Great run there by number 24, Adam Hamling, on a counter play. You'll see misdirection. He goes to the left side, and he's all open with a great run down to about the 3-yard line.
And Hamling is the one who's injured on the far side. And he's got the trainers out there tending to him. They say he stepped out of bounds at the 2-yard line. It'll be first down and goal for the Flyers as they try to match the Broncos, who scored on their opening drive. Humphrey St. Francis tried to take advantage of that great field position after that superb defensive stand. 3 minutes, 35 seconds remaining, and Hamling is up walking around. And they'll keep him on the other side of the field. Pfeiffer's in there, number 88. Andy Claussen has checked in, number 84. He's the fullback behind Callie Baumgart. First down and goal from the two. Pfeiffer now sets up in a split formation. And Baumgart gives it to the fullback. And that was Claussen who came in. He stopped just short of the goal line. About 6 inches shy. Second down and less than one for the Flyers. They're knocking on the door here.
Straight up to the fullback. Tries to inch forward to the goal line. Mullen says, no way. And he's second and inches from the goal line.
Baumgart under center. Claussen and Pfeiffer behind him. And it's Claussen again. This time he's in there for the touchdown.
They went to the right side last time. This time they'll go to the left side. And Andy Claussen with the one-yard run to even up the score, 6-6.
Well, it was the big run by Andy Hamling on that counter action up the wingback spot that got the big carry. 6-6 is our score, the point after try. Jason Anderson, Baumgart's hold, the kick is up, and the kick is good, and so a 2:52 to play in the opening quarter. Humphrey St. Francis has taken a 7-6 lead on Andy Claussen's one-yard touchdown run.
And what set that up was the big three and out earlier for the defense of Humphrey St. Francis, holding Mullen to three and out, getting great field position. And that's exactly what this team did to get here to the championship game in their semifinal victory. They had 11 sacks, 7 forced fumbles, and 2 interceptions to defeat Polk Hordeville. So this defense is their big game plan to stop Mullen and get the offense great field position.
Well, you have to feel sorry for Andy Hamling. He got him down there, and he can't celebrate with his teammates. He's on the other side of the field behind the Mullen bench getting his ankle retaped. 7-6 is our score. Humphrey St. Francis with the lead here in the first quarter. And Jason Anderson will kick the football away. Joseph Mackey will be back deep to receive. The last time we saw this scenario, Mackey took the football about 5 yards deep in the end zone and brought it out. Mullen then went on to score on the game's opening drive. And it'll be Mackey taking the football at the one-yard line. He'll bring it to the near side. Nice hole opening up. Hit hard, though. Boy, the Flyers closed tremendously well. Mackey brings the football out to the 20-yard line, and that's where the Broncos will set up shop.
Number 99, Tim Turnus, with a great initial hit on Joseph Mackey to slow his progress down and allow the rest of the team to tackle him. Great hit there by number 99, Tim Turnus.
Well, it looked like there was a hole opening up there, and it closed quickly. First and 10 from the 20. Decent field position now for the Broncos. Jacobs turns, pitches to Simonson. He's got some room to run, and he's going to go all the way. One man closing on him. 5 and touchdown. Jason Anderson closed quickly, but Simons was able to win the foot race and get into the end zone for the touchdown.
Number 10, Nick Simonson, straight up the middle, gets tripped up a little bit, and great balance, as you'll see. Off to the right side, he cuts it up to the middle, gets tripped up, great balance in midfield, and then great acceleration. Number 73, one last chance, can't get him, touchdown.
And on the two-point try, Simonson is stacked up at the line of scrimmage, and the two-point try fails. And Mullen very quickly has regained the lead at 12-7 with 2:35 left to play.
Great run there. Great balance in midfield, enough to get the acceleration going again and just get by number 73, Anderson.
Anderson showed tremendous speed from his linebacker spot, but just wasn't able to close in on Simonson. But you're right, a tremendous run and a great hole off that left side.
And so far in these three state championship football games been played, three times we've seen first play touchdowns opening up. So big plays early in the series. As you see it one more time, Simonson going all the way.
Look at Anderson closing quickly. Just got his foot at the five-yard line, but Simonson was able to get into the end zone for the score. So here we go. Humphrey St. Francis, after taking the lead, has got some work to do once again. Here's Pfeiffer out across the 15, and he's wrapped up shy of the 20-yard line. They'll spot him down at the 19. So good kick coverage that time by Mullen. Tackle on the play by number 81, Jess Severe.
Jess Severe, they're closing quickly and stopping Pfeiffer at the 19-yard line.
So Callie Baumgart and company will split receivers wide to both sides. Hamling is the lone setback. First and 10 from the 19. They give it to Hamling straight up the middle, and he's brought down from behind by number 33, Eric Peterson, the linebacker.
The smaller offensive line of the Flyers here holding their own right now, allowing 5 yards on a pickup here by Hamling. So they might be smaller, but they're just as powerful on that offensive line for the Flyers.
Gain of 5 on the play, second down and 5, inside 2 minutes remaining in the first quarter. The ball at the 24-yard line. And this is Hamling, a quick handoff, and he's got a huge hole and shows some speed. And he's brought down at the 36-yard line. So here come the Flyers right back at the Broncos.
And this is what Coach Brown was worried about, the speed of the Flyers. And as you see, Hamling has plenty of it, bursting through the hole right here and gaining enough for a first down. Great run there by number 24, Hamling.
And good strength to hold on to the football. First and 10, the ball at the 37. Tim Turnus coming in now in a tight set. Baumgart with the pitch. Here's Justin Pfeiffer. Got a block from Hamling. Got another block. He's in the open field, down the sidelines, and knocked out of bounds at the 12-yard line.
Number 24, Hamling with a great block. And then number 99, Tim Turnus with another great block, allowing that option play to go all the way down to the 12-yard line. You'll see right here, number 24, great block. Number 99, another great block. And there's 88, Pfeiffer, going all the way down to the 12-yard line. Great run, great play for the Flyers.
Joel Jacobs saved the touchdown. First down and 10 now from the 12. And Humphrey St. Francis has something going here on their third drive. They trail it 12-7 with 1:23 to play. Baumgart will keep it himself, and he's brought down from behind by Justin Young, the defensive end. Nice gain on the play inside the 10-yard line down to the 7.
Number 83 for the Broncos, showing some good speed. Initially hitting Baumgart. Coming around and making the tackle. Good play there by number 83, Justin Young.
Second down 5, the ball at the 7. The Flyers need to get just inside the 2-yard line for the first down. 48 seconds remaining in the quarter. Justin Pfeiffer with a deep handoff, fumbled the football. Baumgart dove in there. And Baumgart is able to recover the football for Humphrey St. Francis. That could have been disastrous.
I think number 10, Nick Simonson, was the initial hit that caused the fumble. And 18, Baumgart jumped back on the football. As you'll see here on the replay, Simonson coming around, and he did cause the fumble. There's Baumgart. Great instincts to recover it to avoid the big catastrophe for the Flyers.
Third down and 8, the ball at the 10, 5 seconds remaining in the period. And this will be the final play. Baumgart to throw. The pass is incomplete. The intended receiver on the play was 99 Turnus. And that'll bring up fourth down and 8 with the ball spotted at the 10-yard line.
Number 42 with great defense for the Broncos to hold the Flyers from getting in the end zone before the quarter ends.
And the first quarter has come to an end. We'll have a fourth down and eight situation at the 10-yard line when we come back with second quarter action right after this. With Chad Haft, I'm Bill Dolman. Welcome back to Memorial Stadium in Lincoln. Getting set with action in the second quarter of the Class D1 state championship game. We've had a terrific football game to this point. It'll be fourth down and eight now for Humphrey St. Francis. The ball spotted just shy of the 10-yard line. And Jason Anderson is in to attempt a 28-yard field goal. Baumgart will do the holding. The Flyers trying to get on the board, and Anderson's kick is good. That's a good drive for Humphrey St. Francis. They march the ball down the field against the Bronco defense, and they come away with some points.
And Jason Anderson can definitely kick the ball. We saw him down there before the game, and he was kicking everything through. So the coach, Tom Ritter, has definite confidence in Jason Anderson to kick him field goals for 3 points when they're down there in fourth and long.
12-10 our score now with Mullen on top. 11:56 to play in the first half. Mullen scored on the game's opening drive, a one-yard touchdown run by Simonson. Then Nick Simonson with the big 60-yard touchdown run later in the first quarter gave Mullen a 12-7 lead. Andy Clausen, a one-yard touchdown run, and the field goal for Humphrey St. Francis, and that's the scoring to this point. We take a look at the numbers in the first half, or the first quarter, rather.
Humphrey with four first downs, 82 yards rushing, and 20 through the air. Mullen with six first downs, 109 yards, and a big surprising zero in the passing yards. Nobody has a turnover yet. Clean ball game so far.
We have had the ball on the carpet a couple of times, but neither team has lost the turnover. Anderson has it teed up, and the ball bounding to Joseph Mackey. He'll take it to the left side, looking for that wall, and he'll be knocked out of bounds at the 21-yard line, and that's where the Broncos will set up shop. The Mullen Broncos 11-1 on the year. 10th trip to the state tournament. They won the state championship back in 1990. They've been knocked out of the semifinals, in the semifinals, the last three seasons, and they would dearly love to win a state championship this year. Number one team in the early part of the year, number one team for most of the year until losing to Crawford, or rather to Ansley. Crawford took over the top spot. The Broncos knocked them off twice and have, for the most part, been the dominant team in Class D1 this season. This is Jacobs keeping it himself, stretching out to the 30-yard line. It'll be second down and two.
Good misdirection there by number 13, Joel Jacobs. He fakes to the running back, does almost a 360 here, as you'll see, and goes straight to the left side for a good pickup of 9 yards. Good misdirection.
Second down, two. And this is the fullback, Eric Peterson, with the carry. And Peterson's got more than enough for the first down.
Good offensive surge here by the offensive line on second and short. As you see, pushing back the Flyers, back in the defense. Good enough for the first down.
They spotted at the 37-yard line. 1 minute gone by in the second quarter of play. And Mullen leading it by two. Here's Simonson straight up the middle. Great line surge by the Broncos and a 6-yard gain that time by Simonson.
It's still early in the second quarter, but you can see the power taking over in the big offensive line starting to blow big holes for Simonson and the rest of the Broncos.
Callie Baumgart with the tackle on that last play. Again, Mullen working out of a tight set. This is Simonson. Handoff from Jacobs and a huge hole off the left side. And Simonson continues to dig up big, big yards down to the 31-yard line. And here come the Broncos once again.
Watch on this replay. Number 51, Roger Licking, the center, blowing a huge hole up the middle. Taking the linebacker out. And there's Simonson for another big gain, first down.
First and 10 from the 31. They'll sweep it with Simonson, and he's hit in the backfield by Hamling. Good defensive play by Adam Hamling, the 5'7 junior. Short gain on the play. They'll give him a couple of yards, making it second down and eight.
Hamlin says, I might not be as big as you guys, but I got the speed. And he comes around the right side there and takes down Simonson. Great tackle by number 24, Hamlin.
Beat Eric Peterson on that block. They'll sweep it to the left side. Simonson has some room to run. Callie Baumgart knocks him out of bounds, shy of the first down. Well, this Bronco team will go left, they'll go right, they'll go straight up the middle, and they'll do it all again.
And again, you'll see the last man to stop him, Callie Baumgart, gets over there with his great speed and makes a tackle out of bounds on Simonson. Baumgart, a big player here for the Flyers. Last man to stop Simonson in a few plays.
Third down and a long one. Simonson on the dive. He gets to the 20. He's got the first down. And it looks as though that's where they'll spot him down. First down on 10 now for the Broncos as they continue this drive, and the chains will move.
Number 33, the fullback, Eric Peterson, making the block on the linebacker to make sure Simonson got that first down.
First and 10, the ball at the 20. Mullen with the 12-10 lead. 9:30 remaining in the half. Simonson again with another carry. He fumbled the football. And it looked like he got it back. And he did. Telling you what, that football is taking some fortunate bounces for the teams that are dropping it. And that's the third time we've seen the fumbling team get the football back.
And in a close game like this, the turnover might decide the outcome. As you see, somebody got their hand in. I didn't see the number. It got a hand and knocked the ball away. Simonson got the ball back, though.
Gain of one on the fumble. Second down and 9. The ball at the 19. Simonson to the left. Had a great block and a huge hole down the sidelines. Knocked out of bounds at the 5-yard line. What a tremendous block in the backfield, and that got him the room that he needed to make that big play.
And after the block by Peterson, you'll see number 13, the quarterback, Joel Jacobs, right there with the block to make sure Simonson gets down inside the 5-yard line. You'd love to see when your quarterback hands the ball off, goes down the field and makes a huge block for you.
6'4", 210, he ought to be throwing that weight around. And Jacobs will keep it himself. He fumbles the football, and this time it's a turnover. Hamlin is there to pick the ball up as Jacobs looked like he was going into the end zone for the touchdown. Instead, it's Humphrey St. Francis who gets a huge break in this football game.
Huge break. You can't say enough about this. You see Jacobs 1 yard away, and there's number 24, Hamlin, right there to pick up the ball. On the last time the ball was on the carpet, he was close to it. This time he gets it, and it's a first down for the Flyers.
A fumble at the 3-yard line, and Humphrey St. Francis has some life here. They trail it by two. A long way to go. Baumgart giving to the tailback Pfeiffer. He gives him some breathing room out to the 7-yard line.
Little draw up the left side here for Pfeiffer, maybe to give the Flyers a little bit of room to work with. They are trapped back at their 2-yard line, excuse me. Gain of 5 here on the left side. Number 51, Roger Licking with the tackle.
Gain of 4, second down and 6 from the 7. Baumgart, again, Pfeiffer bouncing to the outside, no room to run. Justin Young, the defensive end, made the tackle. Also over there, number 42, Joseph Mackey.
Great play there by number 83, Justin Young. He just threw his blocker away, saw the play coming his way, and makes the tackle. Good play by number 83, Justin Young.
Gain of 1, third down and 5 from the 7. Pfeiffer will split out along with Gary Isom. And Baumgart wants to throw. He's got pressure in the backfield, lofts it up. The pass is off the fingertips of the intended receiver. And that was Justin Pfeiffer, number 88. He had a step on the secondary, and what a huge play that would have been. Instead, the Flyers come up empty, and they'll have to punt the football away.
As you see, the offensive line gave him enough time to throw the football. Pfeiffer had his man beat, the ball just thrown off his fingertips. It's a game of inches.
Mm-hmm. Fourth and 5, they'll punt it. Nick Wimhoff is in there. Boy, Nick doesn't set up very far back. There he goes. He'll set it back in the end zone. Don't go too far back there, Nick. Mackey is back deep to receive. Good snap. And a nice-looking punt by Wimhoff. And Mackey will see it bounce and take a Humphrey St. Francis roll down to the 21-yard line.
Great kick there. He's kicked it from deep in his end zone. We thought he was going to go out of the stadium there before he decided to kick it down to the 21-yard line of Mullen.
Terrific punt by Nick Wimhoff. That's about a 40-45-yard punt with the roll.
That AstroTurf, it's friendly sometimes.
You're right. First and 10 at the 21-yard line for Mullen. They were on the move their last time down. They fumbled the football at the Humphrey St. Francis 3-yard line. They have been dominant with the running game. And the ball carried by Peterson, number 33. Somebody got a hand in his jersey and pulled him down. Otherwise, he might have been gone.
Peterson takes the handoff up to the left side. Burst through a couple tackles to gain up about 4 yards. And smash mouth football continues for the Mullen Broncos.
Gain of 4 in the play, second down and 6. Simonson stuffed up at the line of scrimmage. Surges forward for a yard. And they'll spot it down at the 26-yard line. Little, if any, gain on the play, and they'll call it 3rd down and 5.
Good penetration by the linebacker there, Josh Wessel, to make a 3rd and 5 for a running team here. Big play.
6:15 to play in the half. Simonson on the sweep. Can he get to the corner? Baumgart knocked him out of bounds. They'll spot it out at the 30-yard line. It'll be about a half yard shy of the first down. Well, about a foot shy of the first down. He's right at the sticks, and that'll bring up a 4th down and an interesting call from Mike Brown.
Simonson received a great block from Peterson again, and there's Baumgart to meet him head on to see who's more powerful there for a 1st down.
And the Broncos will go. This will be the 2nd time here in the first half that they've gone for it on 4th down. Simonson gets it. A huge run off the left side. He's able to get the 1st down by a bunch and get it the ball into Humphrey St. Francis territory at the 38-yard line.
You'd have to think the advantage is with the Mullen Broncos on 4th and close. Like we said before, the size of the offensive line is burst through, and you see Simonson, not too bad himself, plows through a couple tackles, and Hamlin's the last man to touch him.
1st down and 10 from the 38. Mullen on the move again, leading it by 2, 12-10. Jacobs to throw. Justin Young is out there. He's got it, and he's on his way into the end zone. Touchdown!
Great pattern run by number 83, Justin Young, off the right side. Slants to the left in double coverage. Comes down with a great catch, and it's a great pass by Joel Jacobs. As you'll see here on the replay,
a 38-yard touchdown pass from Joel Jacobs to Justin Young.
Plenty of time there for Jacobs. Finds Justin Young, and he'll go all the way into the end zone.
2-point try, and the pass is caught by Nick Simonson. And so Mullen, with the 2-point conversion, takes a 20-10 lead. Well, they don't throw the football much, but boy, when they do, they are effective.
And this is the 2nd pass that Young has caught. The 1st one was denied because of a pass interference call. This one counts a little bit more.
Bill Dolman and Chad Haft at Memorial Stadium, Tom Osborne Field in Lincoln, Humphrey St. Francis trailing now by 10. They'll have the football with 5:55 to play in the first half.
And the Mullen Broncos, to get to this game, had 3 passing touchdowns to defeat Chambers. So it's not like they don't ever throw the football. They've been 4 touchdowns in the last 2 games through the air.
And for Baumgart, that's his 16th touchdown pass of the season. And the ball fumbled at the goal line by Hamlin. And he'll have some work to do, and he is smothered at the 8-yard line. And that does not help the Flyer cause.
And who's there? Number 83, Justin Young, after a touchdown, a great hit on special teams.
Well, there's some indecision between Hamling and Pfeiffer. And once they finally decided who was going to take it, the ball was fell to the turf. It's a first down and 10 from the 8-yard line, 5:52 to play. And this is Baumgart. He'll keep it himself. Spinning out of one tackle, and he's brought down at the 20-yard line. Nice run by the quarterback, Callie Baumgart. And Justin Young makes another tackle.
Callie Baumgart, the fake to the fullback up the middle. He goes up to the left side here. Good blocking for him. He's got a lot of room right here to run. Number 88, Justin Pfeiffer, there to make a block. And a good run by number 18, Callie Baumgart.
First and 10, the ball at the 20. 5.5 to play in the half. Mullen leading Humphrey St. Francis 20-10. Second man through is Pfeiffer, and he has nowhere to go. He'll pick up a yard and a little more.
Number 10, Nick Simonson, as you'll see, great penetration again through the line to stop this for a minimal gain. Burst through the line, makes the initial contact. Only a gain of 1 yard there for the Flyers.
Second down and 9. Two receivers split wide to the right for Baumgart, and they'll keep it on the ground. And Hamling has no help in the backfield, and he's triple teamed, and he'll lose yardage on the play. Justin Young, 83, the first guy there. Also helping out was 31, Willie Hicks, the defensive back.
The Flyers here try to spread the offense out a little bit, taking two receivers to the right side. They still decide to run the option. Not enough blockers there, and it's a loss of 3. Great play by the Mullen defense.
Lost back to the 18-yard line, third down and 12. One thing Humphrey St. Francis really doesn't want to do is give the football back up to Mullen, because this football team has shown it can strike quickly. It can also chew up the clock. Baumgart to throw, and the protection broke down, and he's sacked for the first time today. Joel Jacobs, the other quarterback, coming in from his defensive end spot, makes the tackle, and the Flyers are going to have to give up the football.
And that's a coverage sack there, Bill. He had plenty of time initially to throw the football. Great play by the defensive backs, number 42, Joseph Mackey and the crew, to cover the offensive wide receivers and allow enough time for number 13, Joel Jacobs, to make his sack.
Fourth down and 12, Wimhoff in there. He got a nice kick away in his last attempt. This isn't too bad either. Mackey fields it at the 30. He's got some room to run, and he's tripped up by number 20, Josh Wessel, and penalty flags fly.
Might see a push in the back coming on number 83, Justin Young. We'll have to wait and see.
And they'll call it a clip against Mullen, and that'll wipe out the great field position. The ball right now is spotted at the 39-yard line. And they'll mark it off from the 36. And that'll set the Broncos back to the 21-yard line with 3:24 to play in the first half. Mullen leading Humphrey St. Francis in the Class D1 state championship game, 20-10.
And with 3:24, plenty of time for this team to take the ball down and get another touchdown before the half.
Well, they have struck quickly. Jacobs will keep it himself. He spins, lowers his shoulder, and runs over the tackler and picks up 7 yards on the play. Tackle made by number 12, Scott Isom.
Joel Jacobs here, number 13, the quarterback, showing his size and power, running over the linebacker. Great run by number 13, Joel Jacobs.
Pick up a 5, second down and 5 from the 26. And they'll sweep it with Simonson to the left side. He's got the corner, and he's ridden out of bounds at the 30-yard line. He'll be 2 yards shy of the first.
Can't say enough about this offensive line for the Mullen Broncos. Number 51, Roger Licking, leading the way, and the rest of his crew giving enough space for Simonson and the rest of the backfield to gain positive yardage. Great blocking the whole game so far by the Bronco offensive line.
2 minutes, 50 seconds remaining. We've got a timeout on the field. Officials timeout. And they're doing some equipment work for the St. Francis Flyers. It's going to be third down and one for Mullen. Like I said, they have been able to grind out the football, pound it at Humphrey St. Francis. They did that on the opening drive, but they've also struck quickly. They've got a 60-yard touchdown run and a 38-yard pass, and this is Peterson off the left side. He's got the first down and more to the 37-yard line.
So many great options in the backfield for the Mullen Broncos, Simonson, Peterson, Jacobs. They don't know which one it's going to, and with the great play fakes they've been doing. As you'll see right here, Peterson gets it initially. Great run, 6 yards before he's touched.
First down and 10 from the Mullen 37. 2.5 minutes to play, each team with three timeouts remaining in the half. Here's Simonson on the sweep. Runs into a whole host of white jerseys. Good gain on the play inside St. Francis territory to the 38-yard line. They'll call it the 37. Nick Wimhoff in there along with Jason Anderson, 73, among many in on the tackle.
Number 83 and number 52, Sean Peterson and Justin Young. Great blocks to allow Simonson to go back up the middle.
Andy Clausen was also in there, number 84. Second down and four to the 6 yard gain, and Simonson is tripped up as he made his cut. Clausen is then there along with Wimhoff once again for Humphrey St. Francis. That'll bring up third down. We're inside 2 minutes remaining in the first half, and I was wondering when they were going to start using some timeouts, and Mullen will take a timeout here. That's their first. 1:49 remaining in the first half of play. Mullen leads Humphrey St. Francis 20-10. With Chad Haft, I'm Bill Dolman. Welcome back to Memorial Stadium. Third down and three. Humphrey St. Francis trailing Mullen 20-10. The Broncos have the football, and Simonson takes it up the middle, and he is going to be brought down at the 14-yard line. Simonson with another big gain straight up the middle into that Flyer defense.
Simonson with the great carry, but number 33, Peterson, with a great block from the fullback position to allow the big hole. You see 33 right there, and there's Simonson off to the races, down to the 13-yard line. Great run, great play by the Broncos.
1:40 and counting. First down and 10 from the 13. Simonson on the sweep, trying to find his blockers, bounces to the outside, knocked out of bounds at the 2-yard line. This guy has had a dynamite first half. Nick Simonson, number 10.
Here comes sound like a broken record. Again, Peterson, great block. Simonson, great run all the way down to the 2-yard line. Right there, Peterson with another great block. And there's Simonson using the speed down to the 2.
Joel Jacobs, also the quarterback, in there to throw a couple of blocks. So it's first down and goal from the 2 now with a minute 24. Jacobs will keep it himself into the end zone. Touchdown!
The offensive line bursting through, and there's Joel Jacobs with an easy 1-yard run into the end zone. As you'll see, the offensive line just bursting through that defensive line, and there's Joel Jacobs walking into the end zone for the touchdown.
Well, we go back to that last Humphrey St. Francis drive, and they needed to work the clock, get a couple of first downs, because the way Mullen has played here in this first half, they have been dominant. Here's Mackey on the 2-point try, sneaks into the end zone, and it's good. And that'll make it 28-10 with 1:21 remaining in the first half. An 18-point lead for the Mullen Broncos.
Mackey here with a sweep to the left side, just waiting for his blockers to do their job. They did their job, and he's in for the 2-point conversion, and now they lead by 18.
Mike Brown has to be happy with the way his team has executed the game plan. They've gotten some great running from Nick Simonson, the senior, 6'2", 190 pounds, Joel Jacobs, the quarterback, 6'4", 210. What a tremendous lineup they have. Those guys are seniors. Eric Peterson's also played well in that backfield, 5'11", 195-pounder. He's also a senior. So you know this game means quite a bit to this Mullins football team. They have traveled a long way to get here, and they have gone through an awful lot this season. Two wins over Crawford. You got to believe that those wins really set the stage for them to be the top team in Class D1 this year. And the kick will be taken by Hamling at the 3-yard line. Humphrey St. Francis, they've got some time. Can they get something done here before halftime? And Hamling is brought down at the 26-yard line. Call it the 27. Humphrey St. Francis has three timeouts remaining. And they need something good to happen before they go to the locker room at halftime.
And with three timeouts remaining, a minute 12 is plenty of time. Great field position, 27-yard line. Good run there by Hamlin to get it out that far to let Baumgart and the rest of the crew take over.
And they'll work with split receivers. Josh Wessel split wide to the near side. Hamlin lone setback. Pfeiffer split to the right. And Baumgart looking at Wessel. Wessel's got it. Gain of 8 on the play to the 35-yard line. And the Flyers in a hurry-up offense. They'll go without a huddle. A gain of 9, second down and 1, inside a minute remaining. And Baumgart, a quick pass to Wessel. That's over his hands. And incomplete. That'll stop the clock with 50 seconds remaining. Well, if you're Mullen now, you don't want to relax at all. You've got an 18-point lead. You've been dominant in the second quarter, but you just don't want to let down and let Humphrey St. Francis take the momentum into the locker room at halftime.
Big down, third and one.
Pfeiffer the lone setback. Baumgart with the pitch to Pfeiffer. Good block by Hamling. Pfeiffer's got some room to run off the right side. He's got the first down and more down to the 28-yard line. And the clocks will stop as they move the chains.
Great block by number 24, Hamling there. He was one-on-one with his block, and he got his job done enough to make sure Pfeiffer got the first down. See that great block by 24, Hamlin.
42 seconds, and the clock will start now. And Baumgart will stop it. One tick, one off. It'll be second down and 10. The ball at the Bronco 28-yard line. Well, you look down to the stands, and everybody's standing up from on both sides.
This is a big possession here for Humphrey St. Francis. They can score. The momentum might come back to them.
Second down 10, the ball at the 28. Remember, they've got a pretty good field goal kicker in Jason Anderson. He connected on a 28-yard kick earlier in the half. But they want six. They need six. Baumgart with the pass. Pfeiffer, he's open. He's got a touchdown!
Huge play, Baumgart to Pfeiffer for the touchdown. The Mullen Broncos were double-teaming number 20, Josh Wessel, as he came from the side, ran a slant in. The safety took him, one-on-one coverage with Pfeiffer, as you'll see here. Baumgart drops back, plenty of time to throw the football, finds Pfeiffer in the corner of the end zone for the touchdown.
A 28-yard scoring pass with 35 seconds remaining in the half, and Humphrey St. Francis will take a timeout to talk about this two-point try. We're going to take a timeout with him. We'll come back with more from Memorial Stadium right after this.
Tradition of excellence is something that Husker fans know all about. The Husker Tunnel Walk is the greatest introduction in college football history. Now, bring the Tunnel Walk tradition to your home. You'll go behind the scenes and see firsthand the making of the legendary Tunnel Walks. Meet the Tunnel Walk creators and hear how the tradition changed the Husker experience forever. See all four in their entirety. Play it before the big game, after the big win, or when you just need a Husker fix. The Tunnel Walk tradition is produced by Snitley Car Production Group and sold exclusively at Huskers Authentic.
Two-point try coming for Humphrey St. Francis. Baumgart wants to throw. He's got Wessel in the corner of the end zone, and he couldn't come down with it. He was open for a moment, and the pass was too tall. So with 35 seconds remaining in the first half, Humphrey St. Francis has cut into that Mullen lead. It's now 28-16, and that was a huge touchdown, Chad, for this Humphrey St. Francis Flyer squad.
Huge touchdown. Momentum's probably shifted back to Humphrey St. Francis. They're only down 12 now instead of the big 18 points, which they were. And they know they can score on these guys. They just need to keep their drives going, no, turn the football over, and we got a good game going into the second half.
28-16 the score. Mullen will have the football with 35 seconds remaining and two timeouts, so it's not out of the realm of possibility that they could put some more points on the board. So Humphrey St. Francis can ill afford to let down now. Both teams coming in 11-1 on the year. Humphrey St. Francis ranked number 9 in the state. Mullen ranked number 4, according to the Lincoln papers. Mullen ranked number one much of the year. They'd like to end the year as the number one team in the state. They lost to Ansley, 46-42. They fell from the top spot. Crawford took over. The Broncos knocked off Crawford twice.
And that was Justin Pfeiffer's first receiving touchdown of the year, so a big touchdown for him.
Bounding ball to Mackey, and they'll reverse it. This is 86, Jay Olson, and nobody from the Flyers was fooled on the play. And Mullen will take over with 28 seconds remaining. It'll be first down and 10 from the 18-yard line.
As you'll see on the replay here, Mackey, I think the play developed a little too early. I don't think Humphrey St. Francis got down quick enough to let the play fool him.
Yeah, Mackey could have gotten to the 18-yard line easily on his own. Here's Simonson on the sweep, trying to find his blockers, knocked out of bounds by Baumgartner. Boy, how many times have we seen that play today?
And how many times is Baumgart the last guy to be able to tackle him, right, making the saving tackle for the touchdown?
That stops the clock with 22 seconds. Remember, Jacobs has gone to the air, a 38-yard touchdown pass to Justin Young earlier in the quarter. The third of four Bronco touchdowns today. And Jacobs on the bootleg. He'll keep it himself, thrown out of bounds by Jason Anderson, number 73, and that will stop the clock with 17 seconds remaining. He threw him out right at the sticks, and it's just enough for the first down. It'll be first and 10 from the 28-yard line. They'll call it the 29. The ball spotted just shy of the mark. 17 seconds remaining, and remember, the Mullen Broncos have two timeouts remaining.
If you're Humphrey St. Francis, you want to make sure you keep them inside the lines to make the clock run and make them use their timeouts.
Simonson off the left side, bounces to the outside. Baumgart knocks him out of bounds. 12 seconds remaining.
As you'll see in the replay here, Simonson again off to the left side, and there's number 18, Baumgart, to knock him out of bounds, but not before they get a first down.
And Mullen will take its timeout. They'll have one remaining, 12 seconds remaining in a long first half of play. There's been a lot of scoring. It's been a great football game to this point. 28-16, Mullen on top by 12. They led 28-10, and Humphrey St. Francis got the big touchdown strike, 28 yards from Callie Baumgart to Justin Pfeiffer. And that closed the margin to 28-16, a 12-point game with 12 seconds remaining. Really haven't seen anything that we didn't expect to see from Mullen. They've run the football, and they've run it extremely effectively.
Very powerful team, and that's what you have to do when you're bigger than the other team. And you got great running backs. You got a two-man threat with the fullback and running back. Then Jacobs as well can take the ball in the naked bootleg and run the distance as well. So a lot of threats here for the Mullen Broncos.
They've got 12 seconds and 41 yards to the end zone. And Jacobs wants to throw. He's looking for Young. Covered on the play. Young's got it, and he's going to score. Touchdown! Oh, my goodness, what a huge play before the half.
What a great catch by number 83, Justin Young. He runs a fly pattern about 20 yards, then cuts it off to the right, and Joel Jacobs finds him with a great catch. Baumgart had great coverage on the play, just a great catch by number 83, Justin Young. As you'll see here, Baumgart right on him, Young with a fingertip catch, and Young goes in for the touchdown. Big play before the half.
34-16 with 3 seconds. Mackey on for the point after try. He kicked it sky high, and it's good. 35-16 is the score. Oh, my. That's a heartbreaking series and turn of events for Humphrey St. Francis.
And maybe Coach Brown should think about going to the air a little bit more. Two great big plays by the Mullen Broncos, Jacobs to Young.
Once for 38 yards, another time for 41 yards. 35-16, just after Humphrey St. Francis had scored with 35 seconds remaining in the half. We said they had the capability to score quickly, to score on the big play, and sure enough, Mullen was able to march downfield. They had all of their timeouts remaining. They used two of them. And they put the ball into the end zone right before the half. Simonson will kick it. It's a short kick, fielded by Pfeiffer. Straight up the middle, knocked down, and that's how the first half will come to an end. And Mullen has every reason to feel good about where they're at right now. They lead Humphrey St. Francis 35-16.
You'll see here the momentum, and the players are pumped right here. Great hit on number 99, Tim Turnus, and Mullen goes into the half pumped up and has one half left to go before state championship of D1.
That was Turnus on the last return for Humphrey St. Francis. 35-16 is our score. We're at halftime in the Class D1 state championship game. We'll have more from Lincoln in just a moment. With Chad Hafe, I'm Bill Dolman. Welcome back to Memorial Stadium in Lincoln. We're at Tom Osborne Field. This is the Class D1 state championship game between the Mullen Broncos and the Humphrey St. Francis Flyers. And the second quarter, Chad, a dominant performance by Mullen. They really took control, and they stole the momentum right before the halftime break.
That's right. Humphrey St. Francis, with about a minute 20 left, came down and scored and brought him within 12 points. And then Mullen, right before the half, connected from Joel Jacobs to Justin Young on a great touchdown grab. And that's where we stand, 35-16 right now, Mullen in the lead, and not just rushing the ball, but throwing the ball as well in that second quarter.
And how about a terrific first half performance by Nick Simonson? 26 carries, 204 yards rushing, two touchdowns. He had a 60-yard touchdown run. My goodness, what a dominating performance. And Mullen said, we're going to run the football. Humphrey St. Francis knew they were going to run the football. They've not been able to stop Simonson. Mullen with 345 yards on the ground, and they have a huge lead here as we go into the third quarter of play. 35-16, Mullen will kick it away to Humphrey St. Francis. The Flyers will have a chance to get back on the board right off the bat. The bouncing ball picked up by Pfeiffer. He brings it straight up the middle and is knocked down at the 29-yard line. Decent field position for the Flyers.
The Flyers are going to bounce back here and score quickly and score often, as they're down 35-16 right now. They're going to need to have Baumgart have a huge game here in the second half.
35-16 our score. And the Flyers will split them out wide to both sides. And Baumgart fakes the handoff, and he's wrapped up and brought down. Little or no gain on the play. I talked about Simonson for Mullen, 204 yards rushing, and we'll see him a little bit more. But Mullen has the football. The record for the state championship game, 339 yards rushing. That was a monster day.
But if he does what he did in the first half, he'll be well on his way to record that record in the D1 championship game.
Gain of one on the play from Baumgart. Callie Baumgart, the quarterback, and he wants to throw here on second down and nine. Lofts a pass out there. It's complete. Caught by 43, Todd Frondorfer, and he's brought down by number 20, Gary Isom. And a terrific start for Baumgarten.
Great touch on this pass by Collie Baumgart. Right over the defensive back's hands into number 43's hands.
Todd Frondorfer.
And great offensive protection from the offensive line to give Baumgart enough time to get that pass to Frondorfer.
21-yard gain on the play. First down and 10 from the Mullen 29-yard line. A minute gone by in the third quarter. Baumgart to throw again. He's got pressure, gets away. He's sacked, tried to get away, and he's finally wrapped up and brought down. Jacobs, Joel Jacobs, 13, the rush in, brought him down. That's his second sack of the football game.
And initially, number 83, Justin Young, was in on Baumgart right away to make Baumgart scramble up in the pocket, and then number 13 will take the credit for the sack. Joel Jacobs, as you'll see in the replay here, initially, enough time to pass, and here's Justin Young coming on the right side, getting pressure on him, and Joel Jacobs is right there at the end to bring him down for the sack.
Loss of five, second down and 15, and they'll work out of the eye. Counteraction. This is Frondorfer bouncing to the outside. He's got some room to run. Knocked out of bounds at the 20-yard line. He'll be about a yard shy of the first down. It'll be third down and one.
Number 73, Jason Anderson, with a great block downfield, allowing the running back here to gain a few extra yards enough to get him close for a first down. It'll be 3rd and 1. Todd Frondorfer right here. Great burst of speed at the end. And you see the great block by number 73, Jason Anderson.
You got to believe Humphrey St. Francis is in a two-down territory right now. Baumgarten with the pitch. Pfeiffer fumbled the football, got it back, and lost a yard. When you're trailing by a margin of 35-16, you would think that you've got to go for it on fourth down. And instead of a fourth down and one situation, they lost a yard on the play. It'll be fourth down, and really lost two, fourth down and three.
And we said before the game, they're going to have to play an error-free game to win this game. Now they're down 35-16. The second half has to be perfect, and that's going to cost them 4th and 3 instead of 4th and 1 is huge when they're outsized on the offensive line.
Opening drive of the second half. 4th down and 3. And this is Andy Hamling. We saw that play in the first half, and Hamling was able to pick up some big yards from that slot back spot, working the counteraction, and he picks up the first down by a bunch, and this drive stays alive.
Big 6'2", 200-pound Todd Frendorf was right there to make the lead block for number 24, Hamling, and Hamling got enough for the first down.
Joseph Mackey made the tackle. First down and 10, the ball at the 14-yard line, split bat set. And the give is to Hamling, the first man through. He bounces to the near side, gets the ball inside the 10-yard line, down to the 9.
When you're outsized like the Flyers are here, a lot of counteraction, misdirection is what you need to get the defense off balance, and that's what they're doing right now. Again, Hamling up the middle, off to the left side for a gain of 5. Good enough to get inside the 10-yard line.
Pfeiffer in the eye, and now moves to the left. And this is Pfeiffer on the counter. Pfeiffer works his way through traffic, gets down near the goal line. He stops shy inside the 1, but Humphrey St. Francis will have it first down and goal now from the 1-yard line.
Great block by the center, Nick Wemhoff, up the middle to allow Pfeiffer to get down to the goal line. Big drive here for the Flyers.
Very similar to the beginning of the football game. Mullen took the opening drive, marched downfield and scored. Humphrey St. Francis, they trail it 35-16. They need some points here. Baumgart will take it himself into the end zone, sneaks it in there. Boy, it looked like he got the football in. And they say he was stopped short.
Wow, looked like he was well over. We'll have to see here on the replay. Baumgart with the quarterback sneak right up the middle. And they say the Mullen Broncos held him, so we got 2nd and 1.
Baumgart, a 6-footer. The nose of the football is just shy of the goal line. 2nd down and goal from the 1. And they'll sweep it quickly with Pfeiffer. He's in there for the touchdown. Fumbled the football, but after he crossed the goal line, and Humphrey St. Francis mounts a terrific drive to start the second half of play. That's exactly what the Flyers needed. And boy, Chad, you go back to that last touchdown that Mullen scored, and what a killer play that was for Humphrey St. Francis.
They showed the confidence to come back in the second half, drive the football down the field, and instead of using the power with Baumgart up the middle, they decided to pitch it off to Pfeiffer to the left side, and he's got in for the touchdown. No quitting in this team. They said they've overachieved all season, and they're definitely showing they're not going to quit in this last game of the year.
35-22. Jason Anderson on for the point after try. They're going to throw the pass, and it's complete. Baumgart to Josh Wessel, and the two-point conversion is successful. And that cuts the margin to 35-24, an 11-point football game. Boy, you go back to that last score that Mullen on the pass from Jacobs to Young with 3 seconds remaining in the half, we'd have ourselves a 28-24 football game. That was a huge score.
Huge play. And like we said before the half ended, Baumgart with great coverage, just a perfect pass to Young for the touchdown. They're only down 11, though. It's a big play there to get in the end zone to bring this game back within 11 points.
Mullen had a monster offensive production in the second quarter. And with 7:46 to play in the third quarter, they'll finally get the football here in the second half. Joseph Mackey will be back deep to receive the kick from Jason Anderson.
like we said before, to get to the championship game, Humphrey St. Francis did force 7 fumbles and 2 interceptions in the semifinal game, so defense is definitely capable of making the ball, turning the ball over back to their offense in good field position. So we'll see what they can do here as Jason Anderson kicks off. Ball goes out of the end zone for a touchback.
So Anderson with a good boot on the kickoff, and Mullen will take over first down and 10. They'll have the football at the Bronco 15-yard line. 7:46 to play. What a terrific drive to open up play here in the third quarter by Humphrey St. Francis. But you have to feel good about yourself. That really builds some confidence. They needed something like that because they went into the locker room at halftime without the momentum. And a quick handoff. And it looked like Simonson once again. Now check it, that's 33, Eric Peterson, the fullback on the carry. He drags tacklers across the 20 to the 21-yard line. It'll bring up second down and 4.
Eric Peterson, the 5'11", 195-pound fullback, showing power there, driving his legs through the middle.
Second down and 4. Here's Simonson on that sweep to the left side. We saw that time and time again in the first half. And he'll be stopped a yard shy of the first down at the 29-yard line. It'll be third down and 1.
The favorite play of the Mullen Broncos is sweep with Simonson to the left side, and they've done it very successfully throughout this game.
Well, to the tune of 208 yards on the afternoon for Simonson. Tight set. Simonson up the middle, brought down shy of the 25-yard line. It'll be fourth down.
Nick Wemhoff with the initial contact, and number 24, Adam Hamlin, with the tackle to bring up fourth down. We'll see what they do deep in their own territory.
Now, this is confidence in your offense. Fourth down and a solid yard to go, and the Broncos are going to go for it. That's also confidence in your defense. Simonson hitting the backfield, hit at the 25, driven back. It's all going to be up to the spot. They need the 25. They're going to spot it back. He lost a yard, and Humphrey St. Francis is held.
Huge defensive stance for the Flyers. What a hit. Watch the hit right there by number 18, Callie Baumgart, to drive back Simonson, and it's a first down for the Flyers deep in the Bronco territory. What a hit.
So first down and 10 for Humphrey St. Francis, 6:39 to play in the third quarter. They scored on the opening drive. They put together a great defensive stand, and they've got great field position here. The ball at the 24-yard line. Baumgart to throw. He's got Wessel complete, out of bounds at the 7-yard line. Humphrey St. Francis is flying high here in the third quarter.
A great streak route, slant route, run by the wide receiver, but number 99, Tim Turnus, drew the defensive backs with him straight up the middle of the field to allow number 20, Josh Wessel, all by himself on the right side.
The gain is down to the 7-yard line. It's first down and goal for Humphrey St. Francis. Two receivers split wide to the near side. Baumgart keeps it himself on the option. Little gain on the play. Wrapped up by 51, Roger Licking, the linebacker. It'll be second down and goal from the 6. Justin Young was also in on the play, number 83.
As you'll see, Baumgart has the option, decides to cut it up the field, and Justin Young's right there to make the tackle.
Eric Peterson was there as well. 6 minutes remaining in the quarter. And the handoff is to 24, Hamlang, and he's pulled back, crossed the 5, got to the 4, and that's where they'll mark him down. Joel Jacobs with the tackle. Jacobs has had a dynamite game as the quarterback and also from that defensive end spot.
Third and 4, probably 2-down territory to get in the end zone. Only 4 yards away. Still down 11 points with 5:30 remaining, but they do have a great field goal kicker, so we'll have to see after this down.
Third down and 4. Pfeiffer's the lone setback. Hamling in the slot. And they'll work the option again. Quick pitch to Pfeiffer. He's got some room, and he's into the end zone. Touchdown! He broke two tackles and was able to lunge into the corner for the score. And Humphrey St. Francis has cut that big lead down even more.
What an effort right there by number 88, Justin Pfeiffer. Two men coming up at him at the goal line. Pfeiffer makes a move to the left, as you'll see on this play. A move right through the left, a stiff arm, and dives into the end zone. And we have a ball game. Humphrey St. Francis only down five with the extra point to go.
Pfeiffer was a 1,000-yard rusher during the regular season. He's had a pretty good game today. And it's a 35-30 ball game, and Humphrey St. Francis will go for two. They'd like to make the margin a field goal. Baumgart lofts it into the end zone. Wessels there. It's good.
Baumgart had a couple receivers open on the play. He finds Wessel in the corner of the end zone for the easy two-point conversion, and we're within a field goal now of a tie ball game. Wow, these guys came out in the second half with great confidence, and they're just rolling right now as they're only down 3 points. 16 unanswered points by the Flyers.
35-32 our score. And the folks from Mullen are shell-shocked. And the Flyers are flying high, 35-32. I'll tell you what, Chad, I thought when they went into the locker room at halftime, after that late score with 3 seconds to go, the pass from Jacobs to Young, 41 yards, I thought that was a killer. I thought we might have ball game right
That's
there.
That's what I
but
thought,
instead,
too.
Tom Ritter got his team adjusted at halftime, and they have come out. They stopped Mullen on fourth down and one, took the football over, great field position. That was huge.
We'll have to see how this game turns out to see if that was a costly call on fourth and one.
And the kick coming to Mackey at the one-yard line. Brings it to the right side, and penalty flags fly. We're going to have a face mask as Mackey gets the football out to the 23-yard line, and a penalty flag comes flying in for good measure. We've got three rags down on the field. 5:13 to play in the third quarter. And you'll see the face mask as Mackey right there. And they'll mark that off against Humphrey St. Francis. It's going to be great field position for Mullen.
We'll see what Joel Jacobs and the rest of the Broncos can do here after giving up 16 unanswered points. See if they can make a big drive and take back the momentum to their side. Huge penalty there.
All the way out to the 38-yard line to midfield. Flyer fans don't like it. 5:13 to play. First and 10 from the 38. Here's Simonson on that sweep. I'll tell you what, this Flyer defense is playing with a lot of confidence right now, and the emotion is sky high.
The speed is overcoming the power right now, and I'm sure the confidence has a lot to do with it on the Flyer defense. These guys are just psyched up and ready to hit somebody, and they're definitely hitting somebody. It's number 10, Nick Simonson, right at the line of scrimmage.
Brandon Pfeiffer, number 40. Put a helmet on Simonson, a gain of two on the play. And Jacobs spinning, getting away, and brought down by Hamling. He nearly broke it.
Great open field tackle right there by number 24, Adam Hamling. If he doesn't get him, it might be six for number 13, Joel Jacobs. As you'll see in the replay, he does the little 360 move at the line of scrimmage, and there's Hamling with the shoestring tackle.
I've seen that 360 spin on the option action with the flow of the play, but never
the counter.
Right. Third down and three, another big play. Peterson stacked up at the line of scrimmage, showing great leg strength down to the 31-yard line, and that'll be enough for Bronco first down, their first of the third quarter.
He is a force up the middle, that number 33, Peterson. He gives it. Goes up the middle and just keeps on going, will not be taken down.
First and 10 at the 31-yard line. The Broncos of Mullen with a three-point lead, 4 minutes remaining in the third quarter. They were three and out on their first drive. But they've seen Humphrey St. Francis score 16 unanswered. Simonson on the sweep, hit in the backfield, gets away, and driven out of bounds after a three-yard gain, knocked out at the 28-yard line.
The Flyers' speed, though, forcing the Broncos to go from side to side instead of north and south. And if they can keep doing that, they're going to be successful. Simonson trying to cut up, as you'll see on the replay here. No room to go, though, and there's the Flyers' defense stretching them out to the sideline.
Andy Clausen and Callie Baumgart to knock him out of bounds. Second down and six. Here's Peterson again. Grabbed from behind and ridden down at the 24-yard line. Gain of three on the play. It'll be third down and three. And this is the kind of drive that Mullen loves to put together. They love to run the football. They love to play the power game. And that's what they've been doing here.
Another big third and three coming up for this powerful Bronco offense.
Third down three, 3:19 and counting, remaining in the third quarter. The Broncos lead it by three, trying to get the momentum back. Simonson hit the backfield, and he falls forward to the 21-yard line. That may be enough for a Bronco first down. And it is. So they'll move the chains again, and the Broncos have put together an impressive drive as they try to answer back the Flyers, who have gained the momentum here in the third quarter.
After the pitch, the 210-pound frame quarterback, Joel Jacobs, makes a big block to allow Simonson the first down and continue the drive.
We've seen number 40 for the Flyers in on a lot of plays here in this third quarter. Jacobs keeps it, and he's hit by Clausen, number 84, and Jacobs falls forward, a gain of four on the play.
Smash-mouth football continuing to be done by the Broncos. Run after run, sweep to the left, sweep to the right, up the middle. And this time, Jacobs keeps the ball and gains a couple.
I keep looking at that Mullen huddle. They were huddled up at the 35-yard line.
They run a mile, I think, today, getting up to the line.
They got a 20-yard jog to get to the line of scrimmage. Gain of three on that last play, second down and seven. A mix-up in the backfield. Jacobs comes away with it. He's got the corner, and he's pushed out of bounds at the 7-yard line. That's what they'll say. He stepped out of bounds. It'll be first down and goal for the Broncos.
Definitely confusion on the play, but it works out well for Joel Jacobs. He just does that 360 the opposite way this time. Takes it for a naked bootleg all the way down to the 8-yard line. First and goal from the 8 for the Broncos.
First down and goal. Simonson hitting the backfield, nowhere to go. And he'll be thrown for a yard loss.
Josh Wessel with the tackle here for the Flyers.
Well, they'll say he got back to the original line of scrimmage, so it'll be second down and goal.
Long drive here, Bill. 3.5 minutes already taken off the clock.
And under two remaining in the quarter. Three-point game, Mullen on top. The sweep with Simonson. Hit, lost the football, and the Flyers have recovered.
Unbelievable. That's the second time now they have turned the ball over inside the 10-yard line.
No, they're going to say he was down. Oh, my goodness.
Simonson getting the ball here. The pitch going to the right side. Peterson there with the block. Very close. Can't tell if the knee was down or not. Huge break, though, for the Broncos.
Third down and six. They maintain possession. Peterson knocked down at the 1-yard line. He lost the football. And they're going to say no fumble on that play either. It'll be fourth down and goal with the ball spotted just inside the 2-yard line.
Number 24, Adam Hamlin there again with a touchdown-saving tackle. He just undercuts Peterson. He's a lot bigger than him, so he has to go for the knees and knocks him down at the 1.
Fourth down and a long one for Mullen. They've been turned away on fourth down and 1 once in this quarter. That was for the first down. Here they're looking for the touchdown. Simonson trots into the end zone, touchdown, untouched.
A huge block by number 33, Peterson again on number 24, Hamlin, the only man with a chance to stop him, and Peterson put him on his back and gave Simonson an easy road into the end zone.
So Mullen, after being turned away, three and out on their first drive of the quarter, they march back to put some points on the board and take a 41-32 lead. Simonson on the two-point try. He's into the end zone. That's good. And the lead is back up to 11, 43-32. And what a killer call on the fumble. Was it or was it not? They say no. Mullen stays alive. They get the points, and the lead's back up to 11, 43-32. And what a tough way for the Humphrey St. Francis defense. Kind of let down the offense just a little bit. 35 seconds remaining in the third quarter.
We'll see what the Flyers have to come back with after that long drive, almost 5 minutes consumed on that drive for the Broncos of Mullen to pull back ahead 11 points, 43-32.
And the kick will be taken at the 7-yard line. And this is Hamley. And he's brought down at the 23-yard line, and that's where Humphrey St. Francis will have it with 28 seconds remaining in the third quarter of play.
That was a very big possession for the Mullen Broncos. They got the momentum back with it. They took 5 minutes off the clock and put their lead back into double digits, Bill.
First down and 10, the ball spotted at the 22-yard line, 28 seconds remaining. Receivers split to both sides. Baumgart gives it to the lone setback. That's Hamley. And he drags tacklers across the 25-yard line out to the 27. It'll be second down and 5.
It's number 24, Adam Hamley's a tough little guy, 5'7", 150 pounds, taking the ball up to the left side here, fighting through tackles and gaining 6 yards. Good run by number 24.
Hamley had 40 yards at halftime. He had 906 yards coming into play today, looking for a 1,000-yard season. And the third quarter has come to an end here in the Class D1 State Championship game. Our score, Mullen leads Humphrey St. Francis 43-32. Humphrey St. Francis scoring 16 unanswered points to begin play here in the third quarter. They close the margin to 3, but Mullen with a late touchdown, and that's where we stand. 43-32 is our score. We'll have more from Memorial Stadium right after this on the Stintley Carr Production Group Network. With Chad Haight, I'm Bill Dolman. Welcome back to Memorial Stadium, Tom Osborne Field in Lincoln. Second down and 4 for the Humphrey St. Francis Flyers. They trail Mullen 43-32 in this Class D1 State Championship game. Here's Hamling on the inside handoff. He's got the first down. He's got more into Mullen territory.
Big tackle there by number 20, Gary Isom, for the Broncos, because Hamling had a lot of open field with his quickness. He could have went the length.
13-yard gain on the play for Hamley. He's now got 73 yards on 9 carries, nearing that 1,000-yard mark for the season. The attendance this morning, 1,446 on hand for this D1 state championship game. And it has been a lively crowd from start to this point. Everybody's been up, standing, watching this one. And the Flyers have given their home folks reason to be excited. And there's the pass, and it's dropped by number 88, Justin Pfeiffer. Baumgart put it right on the money, and Pfeiffer couldn't hold on to it.
Ben Hansel is on the right side. He ran a slant in to take the safety with him. Pfeiffer's one-on-one coverage down the sideline and just dropped the ball. Big play there. They got to come up with those. Down 11 points in the last quarter.
Second down and 10. The ball at the Mullen 39-yard line. Baumgart looked like he was changing the play. He wants to throw again. Protection breaks down, and Young has wrapped him up for the sack. Baumgart falls forward, so he'll get a gain on the play. But good coverage downfield. He had Pfeiffer in the pattern.
Another coverage sack here, as you'll see. Baumgart had a little time to throw, steps up in the pocket, and there's Young, though, to bring him down. 3rd and 8, big play here.
Heads up move by Baumgart to get something out of nothing. At least he picked up a couple of yards. 1 minute gone by in the final quarter of play. Third down, 8 from the Mullen 37. Baumgart to the air again. Pass is complete to Wessel. And he's pulled down at the 18-yard line. Number 20, Josh Wessel, the 6'2 senior. He's made some big plays from that end position today.
A great pattern run by number 20, Josh Wessel here. A little stop and hook, And Baumgart hits him right in the money. Great hands right here, as you see. Number 20, Josh Wessel, bring in the reception and run for a few more yards. They're down to the 10-yard line, 17-yard line, 10 minutes remaining. They got to score here pretty quick.
Joseph Mackey on the coverage. They trail it by 11, 43-32. Been a great offensive performance here in the second half. Hamling is tripped up at the line of scrimmage. He falls forward to the 15-yard line. It'll be a pickup of two, making it second down and eight.
Couple hands got in there to trip up Hamlin there.
Take a look at the numbers through three quarters, and Humphrey St. Francis has closed the gap quite a bit, but they still trail on the scoreboard.
Humphrey with 11 first downs, Mullen 21 first downs. Rushing yards, 155 for Humphrey, 317 for Mullen, 79 through the air for Mullen, 95 for Humphrey, one turnover by Humphrey.
And that came at the 3-yard line, and on second down and eight, the ball carried by Andy Clausen, who scored a touchdown earlier in the game. He's ridden down in the backfield by Justin Young.
And Justin Young coming up with two big plays here on this drive, pressuring Baumgart, almost with a sack previously, and now a big play there to stop the running back.
Third down and 10. And the Broncos can look past now defensively. Hamling the lone setback. Check it, that's Clausen. Baumgart to the air, the pass is caught, flags will fly. Wessel was there, covered on the play by Mackey. They've got two flags in the area. That'll be enough for the first down. They needed the 7-yard line.
Baumgart, you see, has a lot of time to throw. Finally finds Wessel open over the middle, and if the play stands, good enough for a first.
And it's pass interference called against Mullen. And now, what do the Flyers want to do? Do they want to take the penalty or the result of the play? In any event, it's going to be a first down for Humphrey St. Francis.
And a big play it was on third and 10. They went the pressure of fourth and 10, fourth and long. They'll get the first down inside the five.
And they decline the penalty. And they'll take the play, the pass completion from Baumgart to Wessel. Second down, or rather first down and goal, 9:14 to play in the game. The Flyers trailing it by 11, 43-32. And Baumgart handing it off to the fullback, and he is thrown down by Joel Jacobs. That was Andy Clausen, number 84. Flyer fans didn't like what they saw. Forward progress is to the 4-yard line. It'll be second down and goal from the 4.
Quick give here to Clausen. There's number 13, Joel Jacobs. Heard his name called quite often today. Throws back Clausen. They'll give him ball at the 4-yard line, though.
Clausen, the fullback. Pfeiffer will set up to his right. And Baumgart to throw. Pass is caught in the end zone. Touchdown. Todd Frondorfer, number 43, with the touchdown catch. And the Flyers are back on the board.
Frondorfer and Wessel ran crossing patterns, confused the defense. The two defensive backs ran into each other, leaving Frondorfer all alone in the end zone for the touchdown. Right here, they'll cross. Baumgartner finds Frondorfer for the touchdown.
And they'll go for two. That'll make, if they can convert here, that'll make it a 3-point game, and that's key because they do have a pretty good field goal kicker. Baumgart, the option. Pfeiffer has no chance. So the conversion try fails, and it's a 5-point game, 43-38. And we've got a Flyer hurt down on the field, or at least slow in getting up. And that was Pfeiffer, who was hit hard on the play. Understandably, he had no help out there after he took the pitch.
And in running the option game is very crucial for the pitch to be clean to the running back. And today it's been kind of shaky for the Flyers. Again, there is thrown behind Pfeiffer. And when that happens, the play kind of breaks down. The timing's off. And there, as you see, the Broncos held to keep a lead of 5 points.
43-38 is our score. The Mullen Broncos, 11-1 on the year. The Humphrey St. Francis Flyers, also 11-1. Humphrey St. Francis won state championships in 1995 and again in 96. Last year, they had an injury-plagued season, finished 7-3, lost in the first round. They've got several players who are members of those state championship teams in 95 and 96. Those guys were on the sidelines, though. They didn't get a chance to play, or they were in the stands watching. They want a state championship of their own, and they are fighting valiantly here in the second half. They trailed at halftime to Mullen, who put on a clinic in the second quarter of play. But here in the third quarter and the early part of the fourth quarter, Humphrey St. Francis has played a super football game and made the appropriate adjustments. They need a defensive stand here. Mackey takes it in the end zone, dropped the football, and it's a touchback. And so Mullen will have it first down and 10 at the 15-yard line.
And with 8:19 remaining in the football game, you expect nothing but running the football here out of Mullen to keep the clock going. The clock is right now is against Humphrey St. Francis, so they'll run the football and try to run this clock during the drive.
But they've got to be careful with it. We've seen the football on the carpet a couple of times from Mullen. And immediately after taking the handoff, Eric Peterson is knocked down at the line of scrimmage.
This Humphrey St. Francis defense is pumped up right now. They know a big stance, and they'll give the ball back to the offense with a chance to take the lead late in the fourth quarter.
Credit Nick Wimhoff on the play. The nose tackle just went one-on-one with Roger Licking, the center, and pushed Licking into Peterson, and that knocked him down. A loss of one on the play, second down and 11 from the 14-yard line. They'll sweep it with Simonson. He's got blockers off that right side, but the good pursuit by Humphrey St. Francis brings him down after a short gain out to the 17-yard line. It'll be third down and 8.
The speed of the Flyers' defense, again, is making the Broncos go from side to side instead of north and south. And again, third and long for a running team. Big play coming up for the Flyers' defense.
Tom Ritter pacing the sidelines. His team has a huge play here. Third down and 8. Baumgart to throw. The pressure's on. The pass is lofted out there and caught for a first down, number 85, David Ridenour. His first catch of the ball game, and it's a big one. He keeps the drive alive.
What a catch by David Ridenour, and what a throw by Jacobs as he's having pressure on his back by number 73, Jason Anderson. Great catch and a first down for the Broncos.
Baumgart had good coverage on the play. That's the second time he's covered the receiver well, and the receivers come down with it. Go back to that touchdown at the end of the first half on Justin Young's score. Here's Simonson wrapped up after a short gain. He falls forward to the 30-yard line. It'll be second down and 8. 7 minutes remaining. Mullen would love to see that clock continue to wind down. They lead it by 5, 43-38.
Good pursuit by the defensive ends on that last play by the Flyers to minimize the gain of 2 yards.
Second down 8. The ball at the 30. Here's Simonson, trying to find room along the near side. And he's brought down from behind by Josh Wessel, number 20, the linebacker.
They're not gaining a lot of yards on each carry, but they are running the clock and gaining positive yards each time. 2 minutes to run off the clock.
And the ball is spotted at about the 38-yard line. Close enough for a measurement. That's why we've got the stoppage of play. A little more than a foot shy. And that'll make it third down and 1.
Both teams have all 3 timeouts remaining with 6:26 left in this football game. And it's up to the coach to decide when to strategize and take those timeouts.
Mullen make good use of their timeouts at the end of the first half, and then surprised Humphrey St. Francis with the big pass play. Third down and 1. Tight set, everybody bunched up at the line of scrimmage. Simonson hops over the line of scrimmage and is able to pick up the first down and get the ball into St. Francis territory at the 49-yard line. It'll be first down and 10 for Mullen. They lead it by five. And once again, Humphrey St. Francis is seeing their defense falter a little bit. They'd like to get the football back. They had the great stand at the beginning of the third quarter after they scored, holding Mullen four and out. They had to give up, Mullen had to give up possession of the football. And the Flyers punch the football into the end zone for another score. Jacobs on that 360 spin, that counter action. And he's able to fall forward to the 31-yard line.
Jacobs might be able to put a patent on that move because I've never seen it go 360 counter the opposite direction. But you know what? It's worked four times this game for Jacobs. So a great play again by the quarterback of Mullen.
I think he spun the other way that time. Instead of going back, I think he spun forward. And back.
He's a man of variety.
Second down and three. Simonson straight up the middle, bowling his way forward, and looks like he has another Mullen first down. And the clock has stopped with 5:26 to play. Humphrey St. Francis needs a stop. They need a turnover. They need to get the football back.
If they can get a stop and they score again, they can take the lead. But if the clock keeps on going and then Mullen scores, they're in trouble.
And we've got a timeout on the field called by Humphrey St. Francis. It'll be first down and 10 for Mullen when we come back to Memorial Stadium right after this. With Chad Haft, I'm Bill Dolman. 43-38 our score. Mullen on top of Humphrey St. Francis in the Class D1 state championship game. 5:26 to play. First down and 10 for the Broncos at the Humphrey St. Francis 28-yard line. They've been chewing up the clock and chewing up the yards and trying to get some more distance. Simonson has run out of bounds at the 25-yard line.
Number 85 for Humphrey St. Francis there. Tyler Zach throwing off a block and making Simonson go out of bounds. As you'll see, number 85 here throwing the block off and forcing Simonson to get out of bounds. Good defensive stance there by the Flyers.
The ball at the 25-yard line. Second down, seven. Simonson bouncing to the outside. He's got room to run. Big yards, cuts back in. Touchdown! What a terrific run, a 25-yard touchdown run by Nick Simonson. He has had a terrific day for Mullen, and that may be the blow that they needed to knock out the Humphrey St. Francis Flyers.
And you'll see Simonson cuts to the left side, breaks it up, and then cuts back to the right up the middle. Good enough for the touchdown. Great run, great athlete here, that number 10, Nick Simonson.
Not only did he break the tackles, but he also stayed in bounds. And they'll go for the two-point try. Justin Young in the end zone. He's got it. And the conversion is good. And Mullen with a terrific drive, 51-38. Humphrey St. Francis scored 16 unanswered points to start the third quarter of play. But Mullen has been able to answer back every time they've been challenged. And Simonson, 42 carries on the day now for 267 yards and four touchdowns.
He's closing on that record.
Do you think he's going to remember this day for a while?
Oh, I think so. Great run there. Might put the last knee on the coffin. There's still 5:14 remaining. These guys can throw a long pass and score quickly and hold again, but that had to hurt.
Well, Mullen came in averaging 50 points a game, just over that, and they topped that mark with 51. Pfeiffer takes it at the 3-yard line, straight up the gut, and smacked down by Justin Young.
Oh, my gosh. Justin Young just took his head off.
Watch this hit by Justin Young and Jason. Justin Pfeiffer got up and kind of looked like, who just hit me? Well, he wasn't alone either.
Number 75.
30, yeah, 75 was in there. Casey Tykert. First down and 10. The ball at the 16-yard line. 5:09 remaining. Baumgart wanted to throw. Nobody open. Had to take it himself. And he's wrapped up by Young and Jacobs. Those two defensive ends have been dynamite, both on defense, but also as the quarterback and the wide receiver for Mullen.
Baumgart drops back to pass. Pressured right away, tries to step in the pocket, and there's the two defensive ends coming in and taking him down. Clock runs. That was not what Humphrey St. Francis needed. They need to score and score quickly.
They have two timeouts remaining. Pfeiffer split out to the near side. Wessel split to the far side. Hamling is the lone setback. Blitz straight up the middle. Peterson. He was blocked, but Licking, 51, was there to bring him down. They put the heat on the Flyers, and it paid off. And you can sense that the folks in black and gold, well, they believe that that 300-mile trek from Mullen has been worth it. They're 4 minutes and 10 seconds away from their first state championship since 1990.
Roger Licking with the sack. That's two in a row for the Broncos of Mullen. 4 minutes remaining in the game and third and 11. Huge down for St. Francis.
The ball back at the 15-yard line. Hamling and Pfeiffer. Split in the backfield. Baumgart sets up the screen. It's to Pfeiffer. They've got it set up well. Pfeiffer cuts back to the midfield. And it'll be well short of the first down. Out to the 21-yard line, it'll be fourth down and five.
Somehow, number 10, Nick Simonson, had four guys coming at him to block him. He got through him and slowed up Hamling and allowed the rest of the defense to come at him. You'll see right here, number 10, sneak through there, get an arm on him, and Pfeiffer's brought down by number 83, Justin Young.
Fourth down and five, 3:10 to play in the game, and the Flyers are going for it. They've got to. Baumgart to throw, the pass, incomplete. Wessel trapped it, and Mullen will take over on downs with tremendous field position at the 21-yard line. And Wessel gets up and doesn't get up. He's looks like he's hurt on the play.
Baumgart dropped back to pass and just didn't get enough on the pass. Wessel made a great attempt for it, but it wasn't enough.
So the Mullen Broncos with 3:03 to play in this Class D1 state championship game can sense victory. 51-38 is our score. They have withstood a valiant effort by Humphrey St. Francis here in the second half. They led big at halftime. And Humphrey St. Francis scored 69 points to begin the third quarter of play. 35-16 was our score at the break. And look at the great numbers that Nick Simonson, 42 carries, 267 yards, and four touchdowns.
Unbelievable day and a great day he'll always remember here in Tom Osborne Field Memorial Stadium, rushing for 267 yards.
You know, we talked to Mike Brown before the game and about just playing here at Memorial Stadium. He said, boy, my kids have really been looking forward to this. This is a thrill for them. He said only there's probably only a third of his players who have even been in the stadium before to see a football game, let alone play on Tom Osborne Field.
He said their eyes were about as big as he's ever seen them when they walked into the stadium. A great experience for all these guys to come out here, a day they'll always remember.
And you get the feeling that those coaches kind of love the experience, too, to be able to walk the sidelines where a legend like Tom Osborne once coached. Jacobs will keep it himself. He's into the end zone. Touchdown. And that will do it for the Mullen Broncos.
And what else but the 360 move going counter all the way into the end zone.
Joel Jacobs, the 6'4 senior quarterback. Boy, he's had a memorable day, too.
Watch this. The 360 off to the right side. Eludes one tackler, and he's off to the races into the end zone.
Cali Baumgart had a chance to knock him down, but he was a little bit off balance, and Jacobs was able to take it in for the score. Simonson adds the two-point conversion. And what was once a three-point football game in the third quarter has turned into a 21-point margin now with 2 minutes 56 seconds remaining. And now for the Flyers, well, you certainly hope they're enjoying their experience at Memorial Stadium because it looks as though they're going to finish as the runner-up in 1998.
A valiant effort, though, coming back in the second half. Looked like at halftime It was 35-16, and they were going to roll over and die. They didn't. They came back with 16 unanswered points and made this a football game up until the last 5 minutes. So a valiant effort from the Flyers as well.
59-38 our score. 2 minutes, 56 seconds remaining. Mullen 11-1 on the year. Their only loss was to Ansley, 46-42. They came back to knock off Crawford, and the kick goes through the end zone for the touchback. Lindsay Holy Family, the only team this season to knock off Humphrey St. Francis. And the 13th game of the year for both of these teams, Mullen on its way to a 12-1 record and the state championship. Mike Brown, the head coach, Mitch Pfeiffer, Dan Brost, his assistants. Congratulations to them. They play in the Loup Valley Conference. And they're 2 minutes and 56 seconds away from adding the school's second state title. Here's Adam Hamling with a huge hole off the right side. He's been a dynamite running back today for the Humphrey St. Francis Flyers, and he's closing in on 1,000 yards rushing himself. He came in with 906 yards. Through three quarters, he had 60.
There's no giving up in this 5'7", 150-pound running back. You love the effort you see here. You know you're going to probably get beat. 247 remaining. He's given all he has. And a good gain there for Adam Hamling.
Pickup of 19 yards. Out to the 34, first down and 10. And Hamling again. Off the left side. Wrapped up and dropped at the 39-yard line. And that'll bring up second down and 5.
Baumgart off to Hamlin to the left side. Gains about 5 yards. A good tough run. Nick Simonson there with the tackle.
Two minutes remaining in the football game. Second down and 5. Two receivers split to the near side. Baumgart wants to throw. He's got pressure. And he's going to be wrapped up for the sack once again. They had Turnus and Pfeiffer split to the near side, and a timeout is called by Humphrey St. Francis with 1:47 remaining. And Baumgart sacked for the third time today. We've got a minute and 47 remaining in the Class D1 state championship game. We're going to take a timeout. We'll come back with the final moments of this one in just a moment. With Chad Haft, I'm Bill Dolman. Welcome back to the D1 State Championship game. 1:47 remaining. Mullen leads Humphrey St. Francis 59-38. Baumgart to throw on third down and 7. Then the pass is complete to Frondorfer. Todd Frondorfer, who caught the touchdown pass moments ago, keeps the drive alive with the first down here.
It was the exact same play as they ran on the touchdown. The crossing patterns with Wessel and Frondorfer. And again, they hit Frondorfer on the left side in the crossing route. And you'll see Baumgartner plenty of time. Finds Frondorfer over on the left side. Good enough for the first down.
Joseph Mackey with the tackle. First and 10 from the 33 of Mullen. Baumgart to throw again. He's got pressure again. Hit as he throws, and the pass is nearly intercepted. Covering on the play was Willie Hicks, the defensive back, intended for Josh Wessel.
A good battle there on the right side of the field. As you'll see here, Baumgartner drops back to pass. Looks around, pressured, and throws it up for grabs, basically, and there's Hicks to knock the ball away.
Second down and 10. The ball at the 33-yard line, a minute 34 to play. The clock is stopped on the incompletion. Baumgart to throw. Peterson is there. Young is there. And Licking finally brings him down. Fourth sack given up by the Flyers.
Tremendous pressure being brought by the Broncos of Mullen. No mercy in these guys. They're going to keep on going after Baumgart until the clock says triple zeros.
Loss of 7 on the play. And another timeout, the final timeout taken by Humphrey St. Francis. With a minute 22 remaining, they trail 59-38.
great ball game here up until the last couple minutes of play. Both teams showing strong efforts and showing why they deserve to be in this championship game of D1. Great experience for these kids.
35-16 was the score at halftime. Mullen with a late touchdown in that second quarter. The pass from Jacobs to Young. That really was a killer play for Humphrey St. Francis. But the Flyers came out, scored 16 unanswered points, and after Justin Pfeiffer scored on a 4-yard run, that made the score 35-32. Mullen, though, has dominated since. 59-38 is our score. You have to give it to Humphrey St. Francis. You talked to Tom Ritter before their game, and he said, you know, I thought we had a team that might lose 3 or 4 football games. I didn't think we had a team that could get to the state championship. But they are indeed here. They've played well. They played very confidently. And they really made a game of it in that third quarter. But Mullen, the preseason number one team, the number one team throughout much of the season in Class D1. They lost to Angeley, lost the top spot. But they've been on a mission ever since. And they're a minute away from accomplishing their ultimate mission, and that's winning a state championship. Loss on the play. Back to the 39-yard line. It'll be 4th down and 17 for the Flyers. They will go. And they can no longer stop the clock. And the Mullen Bronco fans can begin their celebration. They will be the state champions for 1998, their second state championship. Baumgart to throw again. Lofts the pass up. Wessel! Pass was out of bounds, incomplete. And the Broncos will take over with 41 seconds remaining in the game.
Their last chance here on 4th and 17, Baumgart throws to the left side, out of bounds, and that's going to do it. Celebration can begin for the black and gold of the Broncos.
They came into this game ranked number 4 in the state, and they will leave with the state championship. They made it to the semifinals each of the last 3 seasons, but fell short of earning a trip here to Memorial Stadium. But in 1998, they made it. New quarterback into the football game for the Broncos, Kenton Young, a junior QB, replacing Joel Jacobs, who played terrifically for Mike Brown and company. Jacobs is a senior. Simonson, the terrific game, 267 yards rushing. He's a senior.
And
a lot
great
of seniors
way to
on this Mullen roster.
Great way to end their careers at Mullen. Jacobs, Young had a great game. Simonson, Peterson, they all had great games today.
Roger Licking as well. And here is Kenton Young once again on the carry, and that will be the final play of the game. And Mullen can begin its celebration. The Broncos are the state champions of 1998 in Class D1. They finally got the school's second state championship, and they did it in dominating fashion with a 59-38 victory over the Flyers of Humphrey St. Francis.
Tremendous game by both teams. Valiant effort by Humphrey St. Francis coming back in the second half, but it wasn't enough. Congratulations to the Mullen Broncos, the D1 champions.
Humphrey St. Francis ends the year 11-2 on the season. And the Mullen Broncos will finish at 12-1 with the state championship. And once again, our final score from Memorial Stadium, Tom Osborne Field, the Mullen Broncos have defeated Humphrey St. Francis 59-38 to win the Class D1 state championship for 1998. Congratulations to the Broncos.